So,
you're going.
Okay, this is Jack Talbert, and I'm recording an oral history of Olive, the dog, that belongs to Melissa Gerard. And Melissa, if you want to introduce yourself for John, this is going for John Bow, for Woof. We're going to talk about dogs. So, just...
Okay, hi. I'm Melissa. I'm going to talk about my dog, Olive, who I love dearly.
And I know where you live now, but where are you from? Where are you from originally?
Originally from Boise, Idaho. Uh-huh. But then when I was young, my family moved from Idaho to the Washington, D.C. area.
Oh,
I grew up in Washington, in the Washington, D.C., the suburbs of Washington, D.C., in
right.
Maryland and Northern Virginia.
Now, to hit a high note on that, you used to work for a person, a notorious person, a person of notoriety that I think...
Yes, I worked, my first job out of college, I worked for the Department of Justice, Office of Inspector General, and at that time, Janet Reno was the Attorney General, and I met her a couple of times. I received a couple of very important awards, and I met her at the award ceremony, because she gave out the awards, and I met her and got my picture taken with her and shook her hand, and it was... very exciting.
Yep.
It was back in the day.
Back in the day. So, any kids? First of all, married, single?
I'm married. Just recently married. We just had our 4-year anniversary. Married to a very nice fellow named Brian Tallarico.
And so anyhow, but have you been married before, first marriage, first time?
That's Brian is my very first marriage. Brian and I, we were late timers, so we were both married in our 40s.
Hmm.
I was 45 and he was 40.
Yeah.
So yeah, late timers.
Probably a smart time to get married at 45.
Yes.
So, Olive.
Yes.
Olive is your dog. What kind of dog is Olive?
Yes. She's a pointer lab, black lab pointer mix.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we got her at a shelter, and that's what the shelter said. They thought she was part black lab, part pointer. So she has the body of a pointer. She has a real thin, skinny waist, but she has the face of a lab, and she's all black, and she looks like silk. She's just black silk, like black like an olive.
Yeah, so is that...
We're thinking that's probably why the people who had her before called her Olive, because she's black like a... like a black olive.
So she got adopted with the name Olive already?
Yeah, her name was already Olive, yes, when we got her at the shelter.
And so how old do you think she is now?
We think she's 3.5. She was 1.5 when we got her. We've had her since 2015, since January of 2015.
Yeah.
So she's about 3-ish.
And you said that you were a late timer getting married. How did the dog play into because I know something about the dog already.
Yes.
About something that happened that was in the matrimonial
yes.
contract.
Before Brian and I, when we were talking about getting married, one of the things he said, one of the stipulations was, you know, I know you're pretty much going to be in charge of everything, but the only thing I ask is when we get married, please let me get a dog. I have to have a dog. I love dogs. I've always had dogs. So Brian, that was his one stipulation, is if we get married, when we get married, we absolutely are getting a dog. That's it. So.
Didn't matter about the house where you lived?
No.
Didn't matter about the job where you're at? Didn't matter anything like
he
that?
Just
a dog.
He wanted a dog so bad. So, yeah. And... so we moved to Washington State. We met in Las Vegas. We moved to Washington State. And when we settled in Washington, we bought a house with a yard, fenced-in yard. And Brian said, okay, it's time. It's time to get a dog. And so he started researching and looking at... we knew if we got a dog, we were going to adopt a dog. So... Brian started looking at shelters and looking at websites to adopt a dog. And He wanted a really active dog because he hikes. He's a hiker, and he wanted a dog that could keep up with him when he goes on these long 10-mile hikes. So he wanted a really active dog, and he was specifically looking for like a border collie type dog. And he saw a dog that was available at a shelter in Woodinville, and so he went to the shelter one night after work to meet this border collie. Well, when he gets there, the border collie had a hip issue, had some kind of injury, and the people at the shelter said, "Oh no, this dog can't even walk a mile. This won't work." But they said, "We have a dog that just came in, named Olive."
Mm-hmm.
They had Olive and another dog that had just come in, and so they went and introduced Brian to those dogs. And Brian just said there was something about Olive. He said this when he got home that night. He said, "Oh my God, honey, I met the most amazing dog."
Oh my God!
Like, this dog, her name is Olive, and there's just something special about this dog. And he showed me a picture of her, and I saw the picture, and I was just like, wow, what? There's just something about her. She was beautiful, and she just had this look in her eyes. She just has very soulful eyes.
Yeah.
And so this was a Wednesday night, and Brian said, the guy at the shelter said, if you're interested in adopting her, get here early Saturday morning, because that's when she'll be available for adoption. And he said, we get a line of people every Saturday, and we have you get here as early as you can and put your name on a waiting list. And so we talked about Olive all week. We're like, wow. And by Saturday morning, we were just like so excited. We're going to go get Olive. We had just made up our minds, and I hadn't even met her at this point. And so we get to the shelter at 8:30 in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
We're the first people to put our names on the waiting list, and the shelter didn't open until 10. Like, you could put your name on the waiting list, but the shelter didn't actually open up to people till 10. So we're like, wow, what are we gonna do now? So we went and had breakfast, and we stopped at a pet store and bought food and toys and bones, and got all loaded up. We were definitely at that point, we knew we were getting her. Anyway, so we got her, and she's been amazing. And she has enriched our lives. I mean, it's amazing. I never thought I could be that bonded to a dog.
I kind of remember a story about a dog eating a bunch of remote controls for a television.
Yeah. She's really hyper because she's a hunting dog. So she's, she requires a lot of attention, and we have to like constantly keep her busy. But so if she's at home and she's just left her own devices, if she gets bored, sometimes she eats stuff and gets into things. And she's eaten, she's doesn't eat them, but she just chews on them and destroys them. She's destroyed at least 4 remotes now. So we have to make sure all the remotes in the house are all put away and out of sight.
You once had kind of told me that Olive understands you, that she's figured you out, and that sometimes Brian has to cage her when you're going away, but she knows who's doing it.
What you mean, when we put her in her crate?
Yeah.
We don't put her in her crate as much now. Now we just let her have the whole run of the basement.
Uh-huh.
I forget what the story was about the crate.
You said every time that you would put the dog in the crate, you would make Brian do it.
Well, that's at first.
Yeah.
At first, but then I got used to it, and I learned how to do it. I wasn't doing it right, because dogs, they feel your energy.
Mm-hmm.
And whenever I was leaving for work, when I'd have to put her in the crate,
uh-huh,
I would be like, "Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry I have to put you in the crate." And she'd be like, "What's wrong? Why are you so sad and scared? Am I going to die?" So I learned from like watching the Dog Whisperer that you act all happy, like, yay, the crate is great. So every morning when I have to put her in the crate, it's, yay, woohoo, the crate is great. And so now she just runs into the crate, and she just loves going into the crate. So that's the trick. So I exude a positive energy.
On the crate. So the crate. The crate's
and so
great.
The crate is like, she loves it now. So, yeah, that's...
And you said that she's hitting her teenage years, and she's starting to talk back.
Yes.
Like she's has to be the teenage daughter, and you're the parents, and you're having to raise basically a human child more than a dog.
Yes, yes. She actually talks to us now. So when she's frustrated with us, she starts talking to us. It happens a lot of times during dinner. Like, we feed her before we eat dinner, but she eats a ton. But when we're eating, she just wants to eat whatever we're eating. And she sits there. She has a chair off to the side, and she'll just get in the chair and sit there, and she'll watch us eat. And she's just looking at us like, why can't I eat that? And or if she's just frustrated in general, she just wants our attention, and we're busy doing stuff around the house, getting stuff, and we just can't give her attention and play with her right that moment. She gets frustrated, and she'll start talking, and she'll go like, rah, 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 and you just, it's just like that, and the look on her face, like the expression on her face is like, why can't I have that piece of steak? It looks really good, and you're eating it, why can't I eat it? You know, you can just tell that's what she's saying to us, you know? Yeah. And she, like, moves her lips, and she has a real expressive face, and she really is talking to us. So that's her thing now. That's what she does now.
So Brian saw this dog. He came running home, and he said, Melissa, the woman that I love, that I've vowed my eternal faith to, I've met another, and she is so beautiful. She is so gorgeous. You know you're getting the dog. You're buying the toys. You haven't seen this dog yet.
Right, right.
So the first moment you actually saw the dog,
yes,
what happened to you?
She melted my heart. She did to me exactly what she did to Brian. We walked into the shelter, and there were all these dogs in these bins and cages, and they were all barking, and just going crazy. And we walk in, and Olive is just sitting there, just sitting as still as can be, just like, just quiet, and we walked up to her, and she looked right at you. Like, you knew this dog had been trained, whoever owned her before, someone trained her in her previous life, and she was so well behaved, and she just sat there, and she just looked me right in the eye, like, I mean, it was an instant connection.
Right.
You know, it was amazing. And I was hooked immediately. Boom. It was incredible. It was just like, it was exactly what happened to Brian when he first met her. It was that just instant bond.
The wedding. You had to go to a wedding. And you left poor Olive all alone. For probably a week. She went to a boarding house, I think.
Oh, yeah, and we went to a family reunion. Yes, yes. It wasn't a wedding. It was a family reunion. Yes, yes.
So when he got back,
when we boarded her,
what had happened with Olive over there?
Oh,
the
yeah.
super well-trained, well-behaved.
Oh, yeah. This was a trip. We went to Florida to visit our parents. His mom lives in Florida, and my dad and his wife live in Florida, around the same area. So, we left her, there's a lady who does doggy daycare who lives in our neighborhood. So we left Olive with the lady.
Mm-hmm.
And Olive, at that point, we had her so well trained, and she was just perfect. We got back, and Olive had just forgotten everything. The lady she stayed with couldn't control Olive, and Olive basically just completely took advantage of her. And so it took it took like a month to get her back in Detroit. The lady we boarded her with said, well, when I fed her, Olive didn't want to eat. So she wouldn't eat her food. So I gave her like little treats every night. I'd make a little, little trail of treats right to her bowl.
Yeah.
So Olive expected us to do that. So we put her food down and she'd look at us like, huh, and just walk away.
Yeah.
Like, huh. And we're like, what is that? What's going on there? And I think she wanted us to do the same thing, put little treats down and spoil her. And we're like, mm-mm. And we would just take her food and just put it away. And just be like, done. You're not going to eat? Oh, well. And you don't eat till the next mealtime. And so she learned very, very quickly not to do that anymore. So we whipped her back into shape.
Do you have a fun, exciting story that you tell people about the dog all the time? Is there one moment that sticks out ahead? I don't know how long just watching cell phone videos of Olive running around in circles at the park, just running. So I know you take a lot of time just filming the dog running. But
she's very fast. She's like lightning. She runs so fast. It's amazing to watch her at the dog park. She'll keep up with... what are those real fast dogs?
Greyhounds.
She'll keep up with them. She'll go, paw for paw with those dogs. She is as fast as can be. It's amazing, and she loves to swim. We take her swimming at the park on Mercer Island, mm-hmm. and oh my gosh, she'll just jump in that water and she'll swim so far and. She loves the water, and it's amazing. And she's super hyper. Like, Brian will take her on, like, a 10-mile hike,
mm-hmm.
and they'll get home, and she'll be like, well, what are we going to do now? Yeah, and she's... and you know when he takes her on a 10-mile hike, she does 20 miles, because she'll run up the trail and then run back, and then run up and run back, and so she does double. Whatever he does, she does double. It's amazing. She's an incredible athlete. It's amazing what she does.
I think that's true with the dogs. They jump sometimes double their, however their body width is, they jump twice as much. It's like you jumping 12 feet straight up because you know, you have to double your height. So you said there was a problem at the airport. Did Olive have to go to the airport ever?
We took her to the airport. She went with me to the airport to pick Brian up. He went out of town for a few days,
uh-huh.
and she went with me to pick him up. But I don't think we had any problem. I had the windows down so she could, like, hang her head out the window. And as soon as we pulled up to the passenger pickup and she saw Brian, she was so excited. She just went crazy. She was so excited, so happy to see him. You could tell if she, like, picked up his scent, and she was just like, oh, I know what's going on now. We're here to pick up Daddy. Woohoo! But, yeah.
So, out of all of the things she's vocalized to you, what's the saddest thing, and then what's the funniest thing?
Saddest thing?
Apart from why can't I have a steak?
Yeah. I guess, you know, when we're leaving, like, she can tell when we're getting ready to go to work. She knows she's going to be home alone all day. And you can tell she just is kind of like, she just sits on the couch and just sits there all alone. Just like, and, you know, Brian will say, okay, I'm going to work. Olive, come give me a hug goodbye. And she's just like, and you just can tell she's just so sad because he's leaving, and she knows. She can tell. We read this article where animals know what time of day it is by the smell, and because they do their sense of smell is so intense, and so by the smell they can tell like what day it is. So I think like when Brian's going to work, he's freshly shaved and mm-hmm. has his whatever. Right. Man stuff he puts on, and he's all dressed nice, and so she can tell when he's going to work and is going to be gone for a long time.
Right.
So she can tell when we're both freshly showered and getting ready to go to work.
That makes her sad.
Yeah,
she's sad when, you guys are clean and fresh and pretty looking, and she's sad.
Yep, she knows. Oh, they're going to work. They're going to be gone all day.
So, what was the funniest thing she ever told you?
She's so many things. She's hilarious. There's just, I can't even. Oh, there's so many things she does that just cracks us up. And is, but of course, now I'm on the spot now, and I can't think of anything. But she.
She ever bring anything out of the water with her when she was swimming? She ever come back and? Did she ever bring you home a present?
Oh, yeah. A couple of times at Mercer Island, she's all of a sudden we'll start digging in the sand, and we're like, what is she doing? And all of a sudden her head will pop up, and she will have found a dead fish in the sand. And she'll be like, and she's excited. She runs around and runs around the whole dog park, and all the other dogs are running after her because they smell the fish. And then she's like, "Food! I've got food!" And I'm running around. And so, yeah, that's happened a couple of times when we've taken her to Mercer Island. Yeah.
Did she ever find anything just outside, like around the house? Anything?
Constantly. She's torn up all our landscaping.
Yeah.
Fortunately, we want to redo the yard anyway.
Oh,
so.
Yeah. Speaking of which, I need to borrow her next spring.
Yeah.
We need some stuff to
when we first started working in the yard, Brian was tearing down old bushes and stuff, and she wanted to help. And she thought, oh, I can do that. And so she started, like, grabbing branches off bushes and pulling them and tearing them. And she's pretty much destroyed everything in the yard. And, like, the people who had the house before us, they had all these solar lights all in the yard. She's pretty much destroyed them all.
So, just kind of a quick wrap up. Something that you would want somebody to know about your dog. If there was one thing, sad as this may be, but you'll probably outlive Olive. And at some point there may be a little doggy cemetery with a little headstone. So what do you want people to know? What's the one thing that you would want that you could summarize in a few quick sentences about this dog?
Just how much she enriched my life. And I feel like almost like she's my daughter. Like, this is as close as I'm ever going to come to having kids. And I feel like Olive is my child. She's my dog child.
Yeah.
And that is what's the most amazing thing. That's what I've gotten out of this whole experience, is how incredible it is to have that kind of bond with a dog. I never imagined I would love a dog so much and be so bonded to a dog. So how much she's just broadened and expanded my horizons. One of the reasons I didn't want to get a dog was I thought, oh, if we have a dog, we won't be able to go here and just go here at a moment's notice and do this. We always are going to have to always come home and take care of the dog and the dog and the dog. Well, it turns out having her has opened up a whole new world for us. Now we're doing things that I never would have done if I didn't have a dog. There's so many dog-friendly things and events, and like, there's bars now that you can take your dog to. In fact, our local bar down the street in downtown, in the town where we live, where Brian goes and does goes and has a drink on a Friday night.
Yeah,
they let him bring Olive in to the bar, and he comes in, and everyone knows Olive, and she sits there really really good, and just sits there, and he, you know, has his beers, and the bartender gives Olive treats, and she's like the bar dog. So she's just how amazing it, how much she's expanded our horizons and enriched our lives. And yeah, that's what I would tell people.
Olive, the talking dog, has enriched our lives.
Yes, exactly.
Well, I think that's a good high note to end on. I think that covers all the things that we wanted to know about the dog. I'm going to change this to we will do. If John says, I like this one, there, he goes through And he picks this one, this one, and this one. The ones he liked, we will do follow-up interviews. Some of them we'll do a follow-up and still won't use for other reasons because you can only fit so much in a book or anything like that. But I think there's probably going to be a follow-up on this one. But given the availability in your schedule, and I appreciate you taking the time, Melissa.
Oh, yeah, happy to do it.
And, you know, and the thing, this is just kind of for John to know. It's not really for anybody or whatever. But Olive came over, and so I think we'll get a picture of the family before you guys head out. But Brian came over, Melissa came over, Olive the dog, everyone came over, and the dog's actually out playing in the backyard right now while we're having the thing. So, and when you were talking, you spoke a little bit louder at the moment, and Olive put her face right up to the window, and I think she heard you through the thing, because she was looking in the thing, and she was getting excited, and I think she heard Mommy talking. She said, well, Mommy said a nice thing about me. So anyhow, Melissa Gerard and Olive the dog, and I appreciate your time today, and I think that's good for now.